The six-day summit has started with senior officials meeting. Today's summit was opened by the Minister of Foreign Affairs, J.J. Odong. Over 100 delegates are in attendance, including those from Libya, Lesotho, Iran, Indonesia, Morocco, Equatorial Guinea, Chile, Venezuela, Vietnam, Algeria, Afghanistan, among others. Officiating at the opening ceremony of the summit, the Minister for Foreign Affairs, J.J. Odong, decried the growing challenge of the debt burden, especially among the developing countries. He tasked the delegates to collectively draw new strategies of addressing this problem so that all countries can flourish in terms of development with limited financial hindrances.
Uganda believes that multilateralism and solidarity are required much more than ever, so that we individually prepare and collectively respond to further challenges. It is therefore befitting that this year's summit will be held under the theme Deepening Cooperation for Shared Global Affluence.
Odong also challenged member countries to address a number of issues ranging from conflicts, insecurity, immigration, unemployment, climate change, among others.
Today, we are faced with several challenges around the world, including conflicts in different parts of our world, food insecurity, migration, unemployment, health pandemics, climate change, and terrorism, among the many challenges that we face.
Further encourage the delegates to explore other parts of the country so as to enjoy the beauty in Uganda.
I want to encourage you to find time to explore other parts of this country and to enjoy the beautiful flora and fauna that exist in this country.
The Palestinian ambassador to the UN called upon delegates attending the 19th Non-Aligned Movement Summit to stand in solidarity with Palestine in the ongoing fight against Gaza that was started by Israel.
We trust this movement, we trust the leadership of Uganda, and I believe they will do the right thing. We are not asking for anything other than standing with us against this aggression. We expect NAM, as it has been, to support us completely until we put an end to this aggression.
Relatedly, as the non-aligned movement and G77 summits commence today, people residing around the summit routes and conference have been advised to plan their travels early to avoid traffic diversions and delays. Some roads around Munyonyo, Buziga and Bunga have been closed to aid the smooth transportation of the delegates.
We've not had many disruptions this morning, but we are going to continuously regulate to ensure that the other daily activities of Ugandans, businesses and movements are not highly disrupted. We also want to advise the public, especially those around summit venues, to put in considerable extra time for travel, including along the designated routes to Entebbe International Airport and Munyonyo, due to the increased security measures. We have a few related cordon and road closures in the surrounding areas. Access to all venues have been restricted to accredited individuals only.
In areas where borders were prohibited, motorcyclists have been urged to comply to avoid consequences.
There is heavy deployment of traffic, and that this traffic will be regulating according to the movement of these delegates. So please, we urge you that you comply with the directives of the traffic officers who will be everywhere. And we are much sure that wherever the officers will direct you to, you will still access your destination.
Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya and Rachel Nachwala for the news.